Hey developer legends, coming up in this video, I am joined by Matt Johnson, Cloud Security Advocate at Prisma Cloud. Matt has years of experience helping organizations integrate security into DevOps environments. He'll be sharing his insights on evolving application security practices for the cloud era, including securing CI/CD pipelines. Matt will explain why we need to expand the definition of an application to fully protect the software delivery cycle. Stay tuned for Matt's expert perspective on adopting a modern approach to application security. Welcome to the Big Dev Theory Up Close. Today, we have a very special guest with us, Matt Johnson. Matt is a developer advocate for Prisma Cloud, and with years of secure software development, he is here to talk about how development teams can integrate their security seamlessly in a DevOps environment. So, welcome, Matt.
Thanks, Stuart. Thanks so much for having me. Big fan of the Big Dev Theory show. So awesome to be here in person and hopefully share some insights on such a critical topic.
Absolutely. So let's jump right in, Matt. One of the everyday challenges that developers face in the DevOps world is balancing speed and security. So how can development teams maintain a rapid pace of both delivery while ensuring their applications are secure?
Yeah, that's the great question, isn't it? And it's a challenge like most organizations will face at some point when they scale up. For me, the key is to implement the kind of DevSecOps approach, making sure you're integrating security practices, tooling, and the right people involved in that into the development process. And by doing so, you're gonna find and fix security issues early on, which is a lot easier than dealing with them later in the development cycle.
Yeah, that makes perfect sense. But you mentioned their tooling. There's so many security tools and products actually out there, and it can be very overwhelming for most development teams. How can they navigate this complex landscape and then pick that right tool for their needs?
Yeah, for sure. The number of security tools is overwhelming, especially if they're all separated kind of by security type, like siloing their alerts from each other. The best approach is to collaborate with security and as early as possible, invite security advocates into the project right at the start if possible, and therefore you'll understand the security requirements, the risks, and the development teams are more likely to be able to choose the best tools for those challenges. I think additionally, automation is key, right? Automating your security testing and your security analysis is going to significantly speed that up while maintaining accuracy.
Awesome. So it sounds like automation is a game changer. But let's talk about a concerning trend here, which is about breaches initiating from the supply chain. How can development teams today mitigate the risks associated with third-party components and also libraries?
Yeah, supply chain attacks are massively on the rise. Essential for development teams to take action. We're doing a lot of work on it internally. Firstly, you should only use trusted and reputable sources. Check what third-party components you're using. Check what version you're using and then monitor all of those versions and components to make sure there's no future security issues with them.
Yeah, I couldn't agree more. And so now when we talk about DevSecOps, security is often seen as perhaps an afterthought or a separate phase. How can organizations ensure that security is right at the beginning of that development process?
Yeah, again, it all comes down to culture really with a lot of this. Security awareness, providing developers with the training resources they need to write secure code. Security, as I said, should be included right in the requirements phase. Threat modeling should be taking place to identify potential risks early on. It shouldn't be part of an afterthought, and there should be, a real security thread all the way through the process.
Yeah. Well said, Matt. I think organizations, when they're moving to the cloud like AWS, there's going to be a growing concern about the shared responsibility model. So how do development teams find that right balance between utilizing the cloud services and maintaining control over the security and their applications?
Yeah, I think the shared responsibility model is essential. For those not familiar, the provider is responsible for the security of the cloud, but the development team is still responsible for securing anything they're putting on that cloud environment, including configuration, including encryption, including, advanced security settings. It's not something that can just be ignored.
Excellent clarification.
And so now with the rise of CI/CD pipelines, we've seen attackers targeting these as well. So what are the prime sort of key security measures that developer teams can take to implement and protect their CI/CD pipelines too?
Yeah, very similar with supply chain. CI/CD pipeline critical. A compromise in this area is widespread. It has access to everything, basically. Controls need to be enforced, you know, authorized personnel only to that pipeline, thorough testing of changes before the pipeline runs to catch any potential security flaws that could trigger problems in the pipeline. In fact, we're doing a lot of work on this, so let me actually show you.
Excellent.
So what we're saying about CI/CD and dependencies being really important for security right now is what we're trying to instill in the new releases of our product. So as you can see here, we have everything you would need from code, contributors, which technologies are in use, which pipeline technologies are in use, be it, you know, GitHub, GitLab, code build, code pipeline, etc. And then you can see all the different end-to-end application lifecycle issues all there. Infrastructure as code issues, maybe some embedded secrets that shouldn't be in your repo, you know, supply chain analysis, you know, vulnerable dependencies. And you can click on any one of those, for example, CI/CD, and see, hey, we have a really bad misconfigured pipeline here, which could potentially allow attackers to take over this project. We can filter by project, as you'd be expect, by category and all that. And then one area that we're really excited about is the idea of putting all this together in a graph. We call it our supply chain graph. And as you can see here, it allows us to basically visualize attack paths. So this project is running this CI pipeline, which is generating this insecure Terraform or CloudFormation. And that's going to highlight, you know, and allow people to prioritize which security issues actually have a real attack vector. And then also by technology, we're going to help discover shadow IT by bringing every single technology in use into one place. So here we can see, you know, all the different VCSs. We can see, we know that some of our pipelines have EC2, AWS EC2 relations, and we can click on those and kind of see, right, yeah, one CI plugin in our whole infrastructure is directly related to creating or modifying EC2 instances. We've got 7 references to EC2 instances in our pipelines, and we can kind of click into those and visualize, you know, what is using what in terms of not only CI/CD, in terms of dependencies and the vulnerabilities we saw on that graph. So the idea is from that one page, you can basically see from your first line of code all the way through your CI, all the way through your CD, looking at any dependencies coming from the software supply chain, you know, maybe multiple dependencies of dependencies back to give you that single picture as to, you know, security across the board. And it's really about, am I protecting my application? It's not, oh, we've enabled security for, you know, CI/CD or enabled security for static analysis of our infrastructure code. No, am I protecting my application end to end, which is what we want to be able to give you visibility of in this kind of single page.
Thank you for those valuable insights, Matt. One last question before we wrap up here today. How can organizations create a security first mindset among their developers and have that security sort of shared responsibility across the entire development team?
Yeah, always the big question. Top down education and communication. Simple as, organizations should provide ongoing security training to developers and create kind of open channels for discussing security concerns, raising best practices. Also, recognizing and rewarding secure coding practices can also encourage developers to prioritize security in their work. But ultimately, it is everyone's responsibility, and fostering that mindset for secure development practices is kind of a company-wide challenge.
Yeah, well said, Matt. Thank you so much for joining us today and sharing your expertise on secure software development, on the entire thing. It's been really, really enlightening.
Yeah, thank you so much for having me. It's been awesome to be here in person and discuss what is such an essential topic. Good luck with the rest of the shows.
Thanks, Matt. And thank you for our viewers for tuning in. If you found this discussion valuable, join me every Tuesday on The Big Dev Theory, only on twitch.tv/AWS. Until next time, stay secure and keep innovating. Bye.